welcome to Atlanta, baby.
You never been to Atlanta.
The Royal Ravens have done what they need to do to get back into the mix. Abizi tries to finesse. The free fire comes in around the edge. Another one challenges. Abizi cuts him down as well. Bruce is, or is it going to be here with Major Mania?
It looks like they're collecting rent here as we are living free. Sim finds another.
It's a good feeling of being able to represent Atlanta. And like even like going to the event, like going through security and stuff, there's a lot of those guys that are actually from the city. So they're, you know, telling me, you know, you gotta represent Atlanta, you gotta do well, and I kept my word with them. I mean, like, we team played very well, and they even came up to me, a few of them, after the event, and they're like, you know, good stuff, making, you know, keeping your word. So it's a good feeling, you know, having that home crowd behind you and having those locals that like just really support you, and they're there for you no matter what. So
I mean, going to the Optic series for our first match, like, one, I just teamed with Slasher and Kenny, so I wanted to beat them even more. But just like the FaZe Optic, everyone's like, that's like a thing everyone's wanted to see in the past, so we kind of wanted just to go out and absolutely destroy them.
I honestly thought our team was like really confident going to that match, because like in scrims we always like beat Optic, so our team was really confident, especially going into like the cave map. That's like our team's best map pretty much, so really, really confident.
I mean, it's scary. So like the overall hard point kill averages in the league, like Bruce Dashy is actually number three right now with an average of 32 kills per hard point. Selim is a step above him at 35. Sip is casually hanging with his feet up at 40.
That's three, that's three. I got double nade, I'm dead. I'm in the back. Look over me.
On the truck, Dashy. One dead. Truck Dashy.
I'm in the back.
Truck.
Oh my God!
Look, it's business, ain't personal. Yeah, money straight, so I'm curving him. Whoa, he been tweaking, something irking him. Did them favors, they was not deserving them. The peace, that thing on him is keeping the peace. I never sleep out in the streets, gotta stay out their reach. With the mob, talk that talk, shake a piece, yeah. Feel so big, talking Papa Shonen Meech, yeah. We had some pride, put it aside, yeah. Cutting the pride with all the guys, yeah. Made mistakes and then I made up my mind. What I decide, I gotta grind, yeah. I gotta grind.
First shot in,
I gotta grind.
Dirty. Yeah.
Oh my god, we don't like that.
Oh my god.
Stay on my grind,
yeah. Oh my god. This just oh my god. Oh my god.
Yo, bro, let's go.
Yes, sir. Let's go, baby.
Wit clutches those.
Get it?
Wit clutches those. Let's go, baby.
Oh, I didn't even realize that was match point for that.
Yeah, it's match point, bro.
Oh, okay. So I probably should come back and win. Thoughts?
That would be pretty dope.
Where are you, Jack? Here you, Jack.
Shit.
Let's go.
Oh my god.
Where was he?
Back left. Put the island on my face.
I mean, playing that London team, we knew, like, that's a team that actually plays us very well in scrims. They have a lot of talent, and a lot of talent that's, like, not underrated. You know, like, they have Dylan. They have Wuskin, who stepped up. They have Scraps. They have all these guys, and we knew going into that match that this was, like, a statement match, that when we play those guys, like, we need to come out and win in, like, dominant fashion if we could, because if we don't, like, people are going to start thinking, like, other things of our team and, like, the reputation that we have.
It was map one. I think we took the dumber stem on Hackney Yard, and we just did what our coach told us to do. We did everything fundamental. I think four of us like went negative that map, but we got the win like pretty good, like dominant fashion.
He's gonna find two kills. He's gonna start earning some time now. London, maybe starting to worse in the middle of the map, but you just see the talent on the face.
I think you saw the movement there. The slide hops coming in from a BZ just looks so difficult to deal with that mid map.
If I ever had to play against this like roster, I'd probably retire. I'd retire again. Yeah. I wouldn't want to play this.
No, they are the definition of twisted when they get onto the map. Short the bottom side of the map as they're trying to break on through.
Germaniac is making again. Sure. They're not going through the middle. In FaZe, they're running a double AR setup, where I think on the other side with London, you have four subs. So, yeah, they're using Celium, they're using Major Maniac.
We might see one more hard point pop. We will, but as Abizi wins that one-on-one, he also wins the map. And Search, it's going to be hard to find a weakness in a team like FaZe on the Search side. Shots. Major Maniac with both. Ali on the next one. He got the pick inside the sight as well. That's a moment for Major Maniac.
He got eyes on it.
Jerk, his brains are gone.
The defuse is going to be coming in. It's a nice stun. He's going to stun that player. Can he hit the shot? Oh, the player's defusing. He hits it. Oh, he doesn't get down.
My God, you thought just maybe a hope and a prayer for Wuskin, but he can't do it all himself, and that'll be FaZe closing out the map too. I mean, we'll see if one pushes Lee down any further. I thought they actually got the neutral before that. The last time we were on, I had realized that London held it, so they did actually get a couple more points in separation from that. How long can they actually hold them? It's been something we haven't seen either team really do. But here a chance to do it. Two players, maybe three, still up around B. Can anyone from FaZe get in? Not going to be the case, as four are going to drop. Simp going to be the lone man in a position to maybe shut it down, but the neutral comes in on B. But here, they seal the deal. Map three goes to London.
Going against London, my main focus honestly was S&D, because I know they're a very good S&D team. And then this respawns is like, we kind of know how each player plays, like Buskins and Scraps, they kind of play like a little bit slower, same with Rated. But then they have some fast players like Dylan. So we kind of have to just like keep our pacing and not work around them, which is what I think a lot of teams mess up on, is like they try to work around other teams. But if you play your game, that's like how you're gonna play the best. So we just came in and just did our own thing.
All right, Atlanta up 2-1. They're gonna close it out. London desperately trying to get this to a fifth and final map. Dylan's got his work cut out for him. Going up against the Tiny Tears. Need to mimic that. Be like the EU Tiny Tear if he can. But the opening break looks good from FaZe. As they'll hop right into the point, Wuskin peeks for a second, and Beezy puts a bullet between his eyes. From London, right? Like, you're spawning your sword second, and Celium is getting his knife.
Celium continues, 17-5. He was just on a 6 grid.
Once this hard point finishes, Wuskin still like the midst of enemy lines. Well, if I say that, he drops. It's Celium up top, doing him dirty.
It's a big one-on-one. Dylan's not going to be able to get across, so Major Maniac, he does his job.
They just push it out again. They can't, like, eclipse. 2-18 from Celium. Are you kidding me?
Well, 33. He's going to find a good timing. Now, I thought Wuskin was going to snap on him, but he's just a little too fast. He's going to earn some time. And, yeah, wait, I mean, you talked about it. For London right now, you have to get to this time, but then you have to worry about Nexus.
Looking for the 40 bomb. There it is, 40 on the board for Celium. What a map it was.
Best as well, they have to get Celium off. Celium, the contest is still in, pulls the knife out. Is he able to connect? He just keeps swinging. Just one more point of BZ, it's his turn. There we go.
To a one round away now. The MVP chance, come on out, Celium. You've been playing lights out so far this weekend.
It's honestly like an unreal feeling, like during that moment, I don't know what to say. I even told her, I'm at a loss for words. But for sure, it was cool, seeing the crowd chant like MVP, and just seeing the trophy and everything. It was a cool experience for sure.
That was probably my first home crowd ever, having people actually support the team that I'm on, because I've always usually gone up against the Optic Gaming Squad, historically speaking. But just in general, man, it was so cool to have the MVP chance for Celium, the Easy AF chance, the ATL. It means a lot. I think it helped the guys get pumped up. A lot of times, even on stage, before we sat down, through the walkouts and stuff, they were so pumped up. I remember Celium saying that his blood was flowing right before he got the MVP chant. I think it hyped him up, and I think it's really important to have that. Just because you want to be able to represent your home city and have them support you.
Yeah, so after we went up 2-0, for me it was a good feeling, but at the same time it was I know we had more games to play. It just got into bracket play, so I was alright, now it's actual tournament time.
Job, obviously we all knew it wasn't over. We wanted to win the whole thing, and I think on Sunday we went into that Minnesota just as confident as we were the day before. Just a kind of unfortunate with the flip on the Hackney spawn, and then the S&D Godrex was just really just cutting down the map with a sniper. But I knew going into that third map, we had Hackney, Gunrunner, and that game 5 S&D, if we got there, I knew we weren't losing just because of the players we are. Game 5 S&D, tournament, life on the line, I just knew we weren't going to lose. So I even told Preston, on our way from the back in the bathroom, bro, we got Hackney, Gunrunner. We are good.
The spawn system in MW can be a little bit wacky sometimes, and if you get the spawns and you hold the side of the map that you want to, it's very hard to break, specifically on maps like Hackney Yard and stuff you saw against Minnesota. They flipped us on that P2 and immediately we went down.
No break's gonna come in. Nobody from FaZe is close. And Minnesota take map number one.
I've always thought they're a top three, top four team. ASIM actually didn't have that good of a series versus us, which surprised me. But the strengths on their team, Alex and Assault and just that whole team right now is just so underrated that they can all go off. They're kind of like us in a way.
I honestly think we got unlucky first map, but second map we just played too scared in my opinion. But Minnesota's a good team. Online they even give us some good matches, so it was expected.
Our series is starting now. We've all been in that situation where we're down 0-2, and I think we all just showed our clutch factor, and it's just one of those moments. There's gonna be maps that you lose. There's gonna be series that you lose, and it's all about how you just bounce back from that. So it's gonna happen to every team. It's gonna happen to our team eventually. So we gotta just prepare ourselves for those moments.
As a coach, especially with this team, it was pretty easy. You go down 0-2, you go up there. We don't have a very emotional team in the sense no one's arguing or yelling at each other or kind of getting on each other for playing bad. And honestly, I went up there and I told them, I was like, listen, I'm going to be very honest with you guys. And I would be, and they know this. If they were playing bad, I'm going to tell them. But they made a few mistakes. It happens. It's not like they're getting slayed out. They're not losing gunfights that they don't. They look good, you know. And up there, I just said, I was like, how's communication? And they said, honestly, right now, it's not that good. I was like, why is it not that good? I was like, what's going on? And Simp and Mike, and they all start talking about it. They're talking about how the small talk needs to be better, and we kind of had a conversation of what needs to change. And I told them, I was like, the one thing I'm going to say is they've all been there before. They've been down 0-2, they've won it. Players do it, that's nothing for them, you know. That's for a lot of players, people do it all the time. But I told them, I was like, just come out there with the confidence that I know you guys have, and you have nothing to lose. Through wins and through losses, we're a family, you know. We're going to lose and we're going to win, but this is the time to show everyone, this is our home event. This is the team that's not the young team with no leader. You guys are going to show the composure and win.
A lot of Dallas did consider them the favorite, and now they face the greatest challenge yet, the prospect of elimination at their home series event.
The man's on a mission right now, and it is to upset everyone in this venue, cheering on FaZe. However, ANC in the hands of FaZe.
Where Priest is, or is it going to be here with Major Maniac? Is he wins the two. That's his third kill in a row. Play going.
I need to see Major Maniac. He's on a 9-streak. God damn, look at him go. Incredible stuff for Major Maniac as he finally falls. The clock ticks down. Atlanta FaZe are going to be able to push this one to a map number 4. Here you go, guys.
All right, I'm stunning over for you, and I'm going top bricks.
We love
that. MC, eat some sugar against us, bro. Feed off this shit.
He shook against us, Chris.
He knows, bro. He knows.
He shook, Lair. Say it again.
He shook, MC. He shook.
I said it to them, too, in the dugout, but I'm going to say it to all you guys. You guys have all been here before. You guys have all been down 0-2. And how many times have you guys won? Literally probably countless times, right? You can't even count on your hand. Same thing. Have some fun. You guys have nothing to lose, bro. We have a long year ahead of us. There is nothing to lose starting right now.
As the time ticks down.
Atlanta FaZe versus Minnesota Rocker here. Hard point gun runner over 32 points. I think it's 33 for FaZe. Minnesota will be wanting to collect. That is what we talk about. Give yourself the position. Give yourself the cover. Assault's gonna get pressured. And I tell you what, you kill one tiny terror, they're gonna come biting back.
Sprat out of the grounds right now. And Assault, we give him a lot of love. 15 and 10. As Atlanta now locked down the warehouse, big shots from Cell. Trying to keep the hardpoint in the hands of FaZe, but a seam cleaned out from the back. Celium finds three. Sim gets one of them. Now Silly's trying to get them through the front door, but Priesta says no, and it's an absolute nade fest there on point. A little bit of unfriendly fire, but that's not a problem. As FaZe keep holding the doors, making their way straight through the mines. Hi ho, hi ho. Silly, what have you got? You gotta keep firing, Silly. Keep shooting. Don't let him through. Don't let him get to your hardpoint.
Minnesota, you need to challenge this. You cannot give all these points up. I know you're thinking about the next spawns, but FaZe don't care about spawns. As they start to fall, three go down, FaZe jump on, FaZe get their kills, and FaZe make it a series, a five-map series.
I think after map two, our team was just like, all right, guys, all good. We just all like shook it off because we had our... If we won Hackney Dom, like we had our hardpoint gunrunner, so we were like really confident that we were bringing it back.
Bro, you guys know that you have them on their back feet. These guys are all fucking choke artists, bro, under pressure. You got this.
Yep.
Take a deep breath, small talk, communicate when you guys are planning, what you guys are doing, how you guys are gonna do it, and it's over, bro. Let's go.
Not gonna be a sniper at play here. Gutterx is not opting for it, but here we go. Abizi opens this one up real fast. He fights two.
No,
that's ridiculous work from FaZe.
However, Gutterx has already found seven. Abizi, though, is gonna find another one here.
Ooh, Abizi holds the door. Silly now gets involved.
Oh, that's a grenade, my friend. No, slide away, slide in, slide out. Oh, shake it all about. Come behind you. And he's gonna get pinched. What did Sim just do?
Sim with that snipe making his way forward. A BZ though, he catches a seam.
Playing his all out in concentration.
Let's go! Sim's pushing through. Oh my goodness, wrong timing, wrong place. Alex finds one. Cell and Major Maniac, they just need to stay alive in a 1v2. Surely it's over.
There's 30 seconds left. Assault's got to go for it. He's got to make the play. He has to hit the defuse. He's got to find the two of them. FaZe, back on up. Let him hit the bomb. Let him make the mistake. There's 20 seconds remaining. This to complete the reverse sweep. FaZe, rise from the dead.
You're down 0-2 and you like start winning maps and then you eventually win the series. It feels so good. Like, You're just hyped up, you're fueled up, and you just like go to all your teammates, you give them hugs, high fives, whatever it is, and you're just ready for the next match at that point. Like, you get the blood pumping, like you just want to keep going at that point. So it definitely like brings you closer in a way, because like you feel the downs and then you feel the highs, so like you're just getting all the emotions together.
It was pretty crazy, you know. Like, I don't think anyone expected Florida to even make it out of groups, and that team has a really underrated team. They have a lot of talent. They're really good at search and destroy as well, which takes them deep into these tournaments, right? Like, they're never going to be a team you can just kind of roll over.
It was funny because, like, our whole team was in the back watching that matchup in, like, the warm-up area, and we saw it was, like, game five, and we were all, like, mind-blown.
Set up deep. connects on the shots. It's all to Arcitys to try and clutch. He can't do it.
Definitely made us like more confident going into that finals match because like in scrims, like and we always like beat Florida, but yeah.
He thrives and he's got 16 kills at the moment.
30 seconds left on this hard point. He relies on the minimap for the rotations, but Priest down.
Hanging out and waiting, but for Florida, outside of a miracle, there is nothing you can do. FaZe at map number one, we're just too strong. Keep it up, they gotta bounce back. They gotta figure something out to try to take down FaZe. One offense again, it's been Fierce and Abizi already with the double kill.
Skies may have to worry a little bit about what's going on toward the bomb site, but Sim's going to try and push him. Sim weak as well, but he will win the gunfight.
Zion goes for the wide peek. Doesn't need to get punished for it.
Sim's going to see him. Sim's going to find the kill. Ken's left. The only information he has is Sim. Now the one versus one. But the round is over.
But of course, if you're FaZe, you're trying to bring it down for the home fans, be the first CDL team to win on your own soil.
Mutineers, a decap on B would be absolutely massive.
You can have some listen-ins, you can do a lot, because Dom can get chaotic right now. But FaZe just doing a nice job of trying to stabilize as much as possible, right? Anytime you see someone from Florida cross that 50-yard line, they are dealt with immediately. And now FaZe, they're pushing for the trip cap. They want it for the final 25 seconds. If they can jump up, they're down by 15 now at the end of the half. When they get three, we're going to have, well, a lot closer to a tied game.
FaZe is one on the favorable side here. So I'm going to the second side. Florida's massive lead, I believe, finishes at just 4 points, 77 to 73. In 3.5 minutes, this is a very, very close game. They do not need to panic just yet.
Someone eventually will get this B flag, right? It's been a little bit more than a minute and a half, but all the fights and Bennett, C, and Priest are maybe starting to heat up.
Florida cannot allow FaZe to keep the B hill. It could be another crazy game! The D kept towards B, but I think Florida realized they have to go. They have to push. They need to get everything. There's no time. There's no time at all left for Florida. And Atlanta FaZe defend their city. They will take the Atlanta home series. A wonderful, wonderful performance from FaZe. A 3-0 victory.
Sim also said that you guys get on like a house on fire, pretty much. You're a family. Do you have anything you want to say to your teammates at this moment in time?
I mean, shout out to all my teammates. MC is the best player in the game right now. Love that kid.
Holy, bro, we're nasty.
Yes, we're so good, bro. We're so good. We have such a good team, bro.
I want you to erupt at this name. It's Celia! Lift that in the air, man. Well deserved. Well deserved. Incredible stuff here for you and your team. Selim, I've got to ask you, mate, how does it feel to be on the stage right now in front of your home crowd and picking up that MVP trophy?
It's honestly an unreal feeling. Like, it's just unreal. Like, I have no words.
He has no words, people. He has no words. But I'll tell you what, your gameplay does, because you are phenomenal, man. What about your team? How much does it mean for you to do this together with your family on the stage at home?
It honestly means the world to me, like just seeing all you guys come out and support. I'm so grateful to be doing this for like a job. I'm so grateful for everyone. Thank you so much for like supporting me.
There we go, guys. What a humble guy. Go join your team. Crowd up, one more lift. Atlanta, this is the last time I'm gonna ask you this, but please give it up for your Atlanta champions. It's Atlanta Bay.
Yo, FaZe up.
Yeah.
FaZe up.
FaZe up. FaZe up. FaZe up.
Let's go.
get much better than that.